Exactly. So you could hear languages like JavaScript, right? It's in the int number. No. Python. I heard that Python can also do this. No. C++ is the main thing now, and Java could also take over the whole market. Right? So,
oh my
so
gosh.
Conflicting.
Yeah, it's like no matter where you go in the world, you will still hear these kinds of debates. Hello, everyone. Welcome to Educative Sessions, a podcast series with people in the developer world about their coding experiences. This is powered by Educative, which makes it easy for authors to provide interactive and adaptive courses for software developers. My name is Li Ngo. Today, I'm joined by Chibuike Nwachukwu, who is a backend engineer with Spleet Africa. And today, we're going to talk about his process of learning code by giving back. Chibuike, welcome to the show.
Yeah, hi, Lee. Thanks for having me.
Hi, thank you so much. Thank you so much for calling. Very late night from Nigeria, I believe you're calling us from. I really appreciate you accommodating. And let's go right into it. So, you know, Chibuike, your story begins with you at university, and you seemed really passionate about learning technology at the time, right? But your first experiences didn't seem to go very well. So tell us what went wrong.
Okay, I got into college 2014, right, in Imo State, Nigeria. Actually got into the course, applied to study in university, that was computer science. And when I re-entered the university, I made some friends, right? And these particular friends were passionate about tech. We were all passionate about tech. We didn't just want to come, go to university and just leave university after the number of years that our course required. We wanted to actually get the sense, right, of the practicals involved in the course. Mm-hmm. So we formed the group, and the sole aim of the group, right, was to enable us speak skills, learn things as we go on the journey of our career, our course of study. So it was actually going well, right? So like every week we have projects, we give ourselves projects, we review our projects, we learn. Those who are not catching up easily, guided by those who are catching up faster. So it was all going perfectly, and we were seeing major improvements in our learning process, until we got into the silly game or the silly warfare of tech wars, language wars, and stuff like that. So
that whole thing, what were the languages of debate in your community?
Exactly. So you could hear languages like JavaScript, right? It's in the int number. No. Python. I heard that Python can also do this. No. C++ is the main thing, and Java could also take over the whole market. Right? So,
oh my gosh.
Conflicting.
Yeah, it's like no matter where you go in the world, you will still hear these kinds of debates. And it sounds like it got you into a state of gridlock for your community. And you know, this must have been frustrating for you. So, you know, who helped you, and how did you get out of this predicament so that you could get enthusiastic about learning code again?
Yeah, so we all, like I said, it affected all our learning phase, our learning speed. So in particular me, because at that point, as a fresher, I really wanted to pick up skills needed. So I was battling with, it tell me that this particular technology, maybe mobile, you can learn code over, you can do stuff with JavaScript, or we could do mobile games. So I was trying to get myself in all the different parts. So fast forward from 2014 to 2016, right? At May 2016, I was into various parts. I was into mobile, I was into backend, I was learning frontend, I was also learning game development. So had I continued that path, it would have been very, very terrible for my career, because there was actually no career path. There was really no sense of understanding of what I was actually doing. I knew I was doing something, but there's no connection. So, but May 2016, right, I met someone, my name Anthony. So I was actually visiting a friend of mine in college, right? So Anthony kind of came to his apartment, right, to, I don't know, like charge power his system. Right. So I came also to power my system, and I then met Anthony. Right. So Anthony was into game development. He was in his penultimate year in university. So he was into game development with Unity. And we discussed, right? So I was like, oh, wow, you're into game development. I also got started in game development recently. So can you really show me what you're doing? And he also got to know what I was actually doing. But during our conversation, right, like I said, he was more like a senior back then, so he has experienced what we experienced, and so he was not asking me that, okay, but from your discussion, you said you already have these particular skills, right, in web, you're also learning, so why venture into game development.
Right.
Exactly.
Yeah, I mean, that's a good question, right? It's a legitimate question because there's some who actually presume that those skills translate really well, and there are some that think they're quite different, and you've really got to think differently, all right? And so, you know, how did you feel? Like, were you, you know, what was your focus now after that meeting and after a lot of that pedagogy and guiding you through, you know, these roadblocks in your career?
Yeah, so when he actually discussed this with me, well, he made me understand that I should not actually be chasing languages and chasing path. Mm-hmm. I should actually solidify myself in one particular path. Mm-hmm. Then use the understanding of these paths, right? Master in one, then somehow you gradually grab the rest path if you choose to branch out. So this opened my mind, right? I saw progress because that was May, June, July, August, right? And I focused mainly on web development, right? Mm-hmm. I dropped my game development plans. I dropped my, if I was planning on entering desktop applications, I dropped most of all those things and I focused on mainly the web. And I saw massive improvement in my career. So I was now fired up, right? I was like, how then could I then able to show other people that, or all of my colleagues and other freshers that are coming into the university, that it's not really about grabbing everything at the beginning stage. We could actually go gradually and get like the best out of what we're looking for.
Great. Wow. You know, and let's fast forward to now, right, where you are with all of your work. And you are now very big about giving back, you know. Who are you giving back to, and why, in your opinion, is it so important for you to give back as a coder?
Okay, why is important? So 2016, I'll still go to give a little bit background about college, how it all started. I started from Anthony. So 2016, a friend of mine, we came together and we decided to like help the community that was actually growing in our school. So we organized a class, or let me call it an event, a mini event, where we more like shared our experiences and shared like pathways and more like discuss the ideas that our issues are facing most newbies in our college, and we are lighting people. And going forward, right, till I left university, we organized all these kind of similar programs, perhaps a yearly or stuff. But I also was also very, very open to talking to loads and loads of juniors and loads of newbies in college, and also of my mates. And I found out that when I actually thought, right, the aim of doing all these things, right, was to help people as someone else helped me, because I was someone who was helped. So the aim was actually to help people and improve their coding, guide them fully. But I actually learned that as I was doing that, right, I was getting better. So for instance, now, if someone comes to meet me about he doesn't understand the particular path is flowing, so I'll be like, okay, so I could help you guide you in code wise, right? I could guide you code wise, but we could have give ourselves assignments, I call it assignments, and I just make sure we're on the right path. And as I review these codes, right, because I'm forced to, you know, understand the coding pattern they're using, so I see myself writing better code. So later in my career, I now found out that what I was actually doing was code reviews, right? And code reviews are very vital to like to a program, because you begin to understand various patterns and how people understand why people wrote a particular code and how you're able to suggest quality code writing for them. So now, right? So when I started writing recently, right? Mm-hmm. So I also find that writing is also a way of me also reaching out to people that I could never meet, mm-hmm. right? Sharing my knowledge. And also, so when I do that, I'm sharing my knowledge also. But people that also reach out to me, like they want to also learn how to write, I can also guide them and also read the articles. So the more I review the article before they actually post them, so I'm seeing better articles than mine, better like writing patterns that I could actually adopt, right, into my own writing pattern. So I found out that trying to help people improve themselves code-wise, trying to help people improve themselves writing-wise, and various ways, like writing, coding, improved my own personality, right? I'm now better at managing people, right? I can discuss with people. I have leadership skills. So it helped me also in managerial role, learning how human management and stuff like that.
For sure. And that's something that I, you know, I never thought about when it comes to cultivating those. I don't like to call them soft skills. I could call them people skills, and they're very important when it comes to working in technology. But it's not often that someone suggests, well, why not try doing something charitable and engage with the community in a way on their terms? That makes perfect sense if you think about it. So thanks for that. We've come to the end of our questions, GBK, if you can believe it. And I want to give you an opportunity. Yeah, it goes by really fast. I know. I want to give you an opportunity to talk about a cause, or you can talk about the work that you do, or just anything that you're very passionate about related to code. The floor is yours. Go ahead.
Okay, so I currently work at Spleet Africa. Right. So we are a prop tech company in Lagos, Nigeria. So we are focused on making affordable living, efficient living, like living affordable for everyone. Mm-hmm. So you could call us the Airbnb of Africa. Right. So we saw a space where people in Lagos, Nigeria, and Africa usually do this annual rentals. So we tap into the subscription model, right? Where people subscribe. It could be quarterly, it could be monthly. And why I'm passionate and why it's really interesting, because I want to see how our market in code, African market, are like reacts to this new trend in technology. So I'm fired up, right, to be part of a team that actually brings this new innovation, like this new team to Africa. So that's
wonderful. And I love that you're, you know, it's an important thing to be enthusiastic about the work you do and to have passion for it. And you clearly do. Chibuike Nwachukwu, thank you so much for being part of Educative Sessions. This has been an absolute honor, and thank you so much for making the time. I want to also thank everyone who is listening or watching or accessing this session, however they are. You can watch more of our sessions on YouTube, or you can listen to them on pretty much any major platform for podcasting out there. And lastly, if you want to check us out at Educative, you can do so at educative.io. You can also check out Chibuike's own work, as well as many other people, on our Edpresso platform at educative.io/edpresso. So for all of us here at Educative, thank you so much and happy learning. Bye-bye now. Hope you enjoyed that session. This episode is available on YouTube and also on many podcast platforms. If you'd like to be part of Educative Sessions, the form is open now to apply via the link below. You can also email me at lee@educative.io. Lastly, don't forget to like and comment on our content. Be sure to subscribe for us as well. And of course, you can learn more about us at educative.io. Happy learning.